Dear believer, let's settle this once and for all. According to scriptures, when Jesus took your sins away, he did it once and for all. Once, you were in darkness, and the word that best described you was a mess. But Jesus picked you from that state where you were naked, ashamed, and empty, planted in you a divine seed called eternity. He went up to Calvary. With him, your sins and shame he carried. And when he rose from the dead, he left them behind forever buried. You were desolate, thinking it was too late. Too late to change your story, but Jesus made himself the all in all for you. I mean, how can one man be the reconciler and still be the reconciliation? How can a man be the priest and still give himself as the offering? He knew the suffering he would face should he choose to care. He knew the weight of the burden he had to bear. He knew how much God hated the personality he had to bear. Hebrews 5:7. He offered up prayers and supplications with loud crying and tears, for he knew what was up ahead, and he feared. He feared, but he didn't stop. For he was well aware that only in his own death can you have life. That only in his own death can you have life. And so he took your fallen state with him to the grave. And when the stone was rolled away, he stepped out of the cave. And you came out with him in his glory. He made you a partaker of his divine nature. And now when the devil looks at you, he sees God in his full stature. The devil looks at you in awe, his eyes and mind at war, unable to comprehend how an ordinary man can carry the fullness of the Almighty God. He said, "But God, this man has sinned and fallen short of your glory." God said, "Yes, but he has now been reconciled through the sacrifice of the Son." He said, "But God, remember that the wages of sin is death." God said, "Yes, but my gift to him is eternal life through the substitutional work of the Son." Satan said, "But God, this man is lonely and weak." God said, "Yes, but he has now been made perfect in the Son." Satan said, "But God." God said, "Enough. Enough. The sacrifice of the Son is enough. The sacrifice of the Son is enough. The sacrifice of the Son is enough. For this man you now see has been reconciled. He has been changed, purified. He has been renewed, sanctified. His death paid in full. He is justified forever. He has been made whole and complete in him. You have been made whole and complete in him. Made whole and complete in him. For God proved his love for us in this, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. So dear believer, Jesus didn't die to give you an opportunity to set yourself free. No, he died to set you free. He set you free. He didn't beg death to excuse your case. Rather, he took your place. So cut the chase. Humble yourself and receive the gift of God. Yes, I know the believer still got some work to do. But as much as it concerns the matter of salvation, Jesus made sure there was nothing left to do. He saved us. He alone saved us to the uttermost.